I have searched to find the meaning of this life. Something that
growing up, I had the average family, mom and dad and a brother. My parents took us to church and to VBS, and we were brought up in your typical Christian home. That all changed one day when I was 8 years old. My parents had to tell me that they were no longer going to be together, and I think that was probably one of the hardest days. I don't remember all the specifics or anything like that, but I do know it was a definite life changer in how I saw the world. And that summer after that, I had the chance to go to church camp, and I got to see more of God's love and how it more applied to me, because before I was just this typical girl. I knew I wasn't perfect, but when you're 8, you know, you kind of feel like you are perfect, and I have the perfect little house and the perfect little family. It was a definite change in my life when God directed me out my life on this new path for me. In high school, I had the goody two-shoes, good girl Christian stereotype, and man, I probably fulfilled it to the T. So much that I began to think, like, you have to be perfect at this, you know. You have to get good grades, you have to be smart, you need your homework done. You have to be good at everything, you can't quit. And, you know, I am pretty sure I just played the role of who a Christian is in high school. You know, college came and the first semester I was there, and I had some great friends, but I wasn't involved in church, and I didn't really go to Bible study that often or BSU like I do now. I knew I was a Christian, and even though I didn't go to church, that was okay because some Christians did that. The second semester of my freshman year, I started getting invited to go to churches because I was more involved with the Baptist Union, and I was seeing how much of a difference it does make when you're involved with a Christian organization and how much your relationship with Christ grows. And I wanted to see my relationship with Christ just grow. The last summer, I think God really got a hold of my heart, and I think that was one of the scariest summers I have ever gone through. I remember there'd be just days I'd be by myself and I would just think, like, are you sure you're a Christian? Are you sure you know God? Do you really know who He is? Because say you just died today, do you think you'd really go to heaven? And think about what you've done. How could you go to heaven? And my heart would just break because it's like, I know God. Like, I know who He is and know He's my Savior, but why am I feeling like this? And I couldn't shake my fear. And I remember that just writing my journal, like, God, where are you? Why can't I feel you? Why can't I see you? Like, what am I doing wrong here? I can't even focus on you. And during that time, Gilbert and I were engaged, and I was thinking, you know, I should really get baptized again, because that way, I'll know. That way, it'll be another sign that I'm a Christian. And but never once did I feel like, oh, this is what you're supposed to do. Like, you know, I never felt like God wanted me to get baptized in, which was like this huge conflict in me because, like, I wanted to, and I felt like it was everything I needed to do. But God knew that it was for me. It was for, you know, my glory and what I wanted, and not what baptism really is. And recently, God had placed in my hands this book called Chasing God, and in the middle of it, I was just so dumbstruck. I was like, this is my relationship with God. I am chasing after Him, and I can't do that anymore because I'm never gonna catch Him when He's right beside me. I'm gonna be chasing after little things and never gonna understand who God is if I'm not able to stand still, look at Him, and be humbled by Him. And, you know, I realized that God just calls me to be obedient. I believe in you, God, and I believe your promises. In the book, it pointed out about how the guy whose son, and who had a demon inside of him, and this man, he had asked the disciples, hey, can my son is sick, can you heal him? And the disciples, they weren't able to cast out this demon, even though they were trying to do it in Jesus' name. And then the woman who had the condition, you know, she came and healed and saw touch just because she believed it could be her father. He said, you know, Jesus said, if you can help me, not when you can help me, if you can help me, Jesus said, if, and the man said, I believe, help my disbelief. So today, my baptism is just my first priest for God, I believe. And I'm going to be a priest. My name is Amber Andrew, and God's changed my life.